वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंद समन्वित श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसोदित श्रीनंदनंदन वंदेराधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजनो समायुक्तं वृंदावन मनोहर वांछाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपा सिंधु व्यवच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं वृंदावि तुलसीदेव पिया वै केशवस्य कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्वत्वै नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो ययो मुदीरयेत् संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीयपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्तियुक्तो भक्ति प्रमदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण देयं सदा परिभवन्नम अभिष्टदोहं तेतास्पदं शिवभिरिञ्चनुतं शरण्यं भीतातिहं पुनदपालभवद्विभूतं वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दं यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमणिचटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गपवधूष्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागर सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामहि कदा कृपां करोष श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्याद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौर भक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद सियाद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकाभदातु संकीर्तनैकवितरो कमलायताक्ष विशाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ जुगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणाभतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासिनित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणप्रियमनंगमदापहारं वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संवी त्वं सिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे संसार सिंधु मतिदुस्तरम मुत्तितरि नान्य प्लव भगवतः पुरुषोत्तमस्य लीला कथा रसो निशेवनमंतरेण पुंसो भवेत् विविधो वृक्षो दवादितस्य संसार सिंधु मतिदुस्तरम उत्तितर्योर् नान्यः प्लवो भगवतः पुरुषोत्तमस्य लीला कथा रसो निशीवनम अंतरेण पुंसो भवेत् विविध दुःख दवार्दितस्य गौरी गोष्ठीपती सिसिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड हु इज फॉलोइंग दिस श्रौत पंथा ओनली ही कैन कम आउट सक्सेसफुल। गौरी गोष्ठीपती सिसिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड he who is going to follow Sauta Pantha in toto accurately, only he can attain success, not everybody. Actually we have less information, I think we have less information about the teachings of Srila Prabhupada. That's why we are sitting satisfied. We cannot understand. If there is no question of common sense, then where from this Krishna consciousness come? Common sense is not there. Then how we can expect that Krishna consciousness can develop? No question. So, Gauri Agostipati Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, that only those who are following Srauta Pantha in toto, having strong faith in Sampradaya, they can come out successful, not everybody. Those who are going to develop new rules and regulation and procedure of bhajan, those who are going to start altercation or logic, going to apply logic, they cannot come out successful. Prabhupada speaking, he who is doing 24 hours out of 24 hours, out of 24 hours, who is doing 24 hours Harikirtan Harikatha, he can come out successful, even in dream. Follow. So what Prabhupada speaking, the Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta, we must give attention. What sadhu doing? The sloka is started with a very important from Bhagavatam 12th canto. Sansara sindhu mati dustaram uttitiryor nanyo plava bhagavataho purushottamasyo lila katha raso nishevanamantareno pungsho bhavet vivido dukkho davarditasya. To cross over this material, fearful material, samsara. Prahlad Maharaj speaking to Nrisimhadev, hey Prabhu, I don't fear your this kind of, fearful appearance. But I fear that material samsara. I don't fear your very fearful appearances. I fear only Sangsara chakra kadanat grasatam panitho. I fear. Naham vibhemi tabauti bhayanakasyo jivharko netra bhakuti rabasa agradangstrat antasajaha khatajo shankukaranat nirhato avido digvadari bhinna nakhagrat trasto smiyaham kripanavassalo dushahagro sangsara chakra kadanat grasatam panita. Someday I can explain, not today. This much I can say, Prahladma speaking, Prabhu, you are this kind of fearful appearance, even Lakshmi Devi fear, Brahma, Shankar, everybody, they don't, take risks to approach Prabhu. But Prahlad Maharaj not fear. Prahlad Maharaj approaching very safely, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Prabhu, I don't fear your this kind of fearful appearance in Nrisimhadev. But I fear material samsara, which is very dangerous. In each and every step there is danger. In each and every step, in Upanishad it is written, in each and every step there is danger. There is danger. Each and every step. Everywhere, politics, fighting, they don't understand, they don't like to hear Harikatha. At all hearing to search some fault. Foolish. They cannot, because Harikatha they can hear, they have brain, they can realize not that. To hear Harikatha, you will have to get enough kipa. Otherwise, you can speak all rubbish, write one note, rubbish note. You are giving to give lesson to your Guru Padpada. This is called demonic character. We cannot give any advice, we cannot give any, you know, Siddhanta Vijaya to Guru Padpada. He is knowing everything. Otherwise, how we can say he is Guru? We should not have that kind of audacity to give, you know, to give lesson to Guru Padpadma. Foolish. This way, Baba speaking, those who are deviated, going to develop some new rules and regulation, everything, not going to, you know, keep faith in parampara, sauta parampara, they cannot come out successful. Not possible. What a sadhu can do, that is written in Bhagavatam. What a sadhu can do. Atah dussanga musrijya satsu sajjeta buddhiman. Atah dussanga musrijya satsu sajjeta buddhiman. Why? Because santa eva asya chindanti mano vyasangam uktivhi pravachanadivhi. Those realized soul, they can give you advice, speak Harikatha. You should realize, if you try to apply your own, you know, brain, you cannot come out successful. So what is the duty of Guru Padpadma? What is the duty of a sadhu? The duty of a sadhu, Popa speaking, there is a, for infinity period, while traveling through infinity material world, jivas are developing some material sanskar, very bad sanskar. A real sadhu always try to cut and throw that hidaya ganti. Ganti means knot. Follow. You can remember in 11th canto, you know, we can find this in sloka. Evam guru pasanaika bhakta vidya kotareno sitena dhira vibhrisya jiva sayamayam apramatto sangvischo atmanamatho tajyastam. By the help of Guru Padpadma, we can cut all our, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, we can come out successful to cut all, you know, anarthas inside our heart. Day and night we should pray to Sudarshan Chakra. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Prabhupada speaking. We have to pray unto the lotus feet of Sudarshan Chakra so that dirty darshan can go away, all aprakita darshan can develop. Only, this is only possible by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. So the duty of a sadhu is to cut all anartha there, deposited there inside the heart of one soul. A sadhu means always standing with one weapon. To cut that weapon means Harikatha, Prabhachanadivi. Atah dussanga musrijya satsu sajjeta buddhiman santo eva asya chindanti. Chindani, they are going to cut and throw. Chindanti mana vyasangam mukti bhi. All vyasan, vyasangam or bad association, due to that some, you know, in Hindi we know, jaisa sang, aisa man, aisa rang. According to association, you can develop. Follow? You can change. So, actually, sadhu always standing with harikatha weapon to cut our bondage inside our heart, to make us free from material bondage, to help us to reach a prakrit jagat. Follow? All different kind of desires inside our heart, coming out of anartha, all Guru Vaishnava like to cut. Pravachanadivhi, uktivhi mean pravachanadivhi. A sadhu is never a flattering personality. Prabhupada speaking, a sadhu is never a flattering personality, because a flattering personality can never become a preaching personality. Okay, no problem, let them do, no. A sadhu, Prabhupada speaking, a flattering personality can never become a preaching personality, not possible. If sadhu going to give some indulgence to our all bad habits is there, that means he is my enemy. Prabhupada speaking, if sadhu going to give some indulgence, okay, you go, no problem. It's quite natural, you go. In that case, he is my enemy. He never want my mangal, absolute mangal. Many times Prabhupada, you know, many times Prabhupada used to say, if I seek the path leading to the absolute good, then I must ignore countless voices of popular wisdom and listen only to that of the realized soul. Pure Vaishnavas, they never like to get bad association. They never feel any taste. Because they are always enjoying the feeling of Vaikuntha Bhava. They never get, even you can discover a sadhu amidst all bad association, all pros and this, that, still his Bhava is exclusive. Rishasinga Muni, you know, somehow, you know, king wanted to bring, but Rishasinga Muni, actually it is not complete example, but still I am giving. So somehow he has no bad association from birth. And Prabhupada speaking, I am not going to Calcutta. I am staying in Gauriya Mission of Prakita Vaikuntha Prangan. It is the courtyard of Vaikuntha. You know, there I am speaking Harikatha, doing Kirtan and hearing all the time. If we can take shelter, if we can take shelter without any, if we can take shelter unto a lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava, without any duplicity, Prabhupada speaking, you need not wait for the next life. You need not wait for the next life, this life you can get association. Be sure about it. Bhajan is not a matter of joking. So here we see, Sanatana Goswami path, Sanatana Goswami path, you know, always want to, you know, out of his causeless mercy, always want to help us, even he is not here with us, but still, he is, you know, Dhyad Bhagavadamrita, all other cooks, everything in Bani Sarup, is always going to help us, anyway. So you see, Sangsara Sindhumati Dustaram Muttitaryo. Only to cross this material world, it takes thousands of lives. Though we can demand, I am doing bhajan. I have taken shelter. I am doing Raganuga bhajan, Rupajunga bhajan. But Prabhupada is laughing, Bhakti Siddhanta says. It takes thousands of birth only to cross this material world. And even after crossing this material world, there is no surety that I can do actual bhajan. After getting respite from the material, what I can do? If I don't do Guru Vishnu Seva, Prabhupada speaking, after getting respite, after cutting material bondage, suppose you are out of material bondage. After that, what do you like to do? What is your conception? After what you can do, after cutting bondage, what you can do? Mukti, general mukti. Absolute mukti means actually muktir hitva annatha rupam. Mukti actual definition is that muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. This is actual mukti. To discover the sarup of jiva, I am Krishna Das, I have no other duties. This is called actually. And in general sense, mukti means to get liberation from prakriti, nature, material world. Okay, well. But after that, what you can do? Prabhupada speaking, even after getting liberation from this material world, there is no surety we can do bhakti. It depends upon our nature. Follow. There is no surety that we can do bhakti. So after that, we can become mayavadi. If we ignore seva, who can say? False philosophy, false discussion, everything can go on. I have no right to speak anything what I am not doing. It is not Harikatha then. So many advice I can give to people. I can give to people, you should not criticize anybody, you should not do anything, but you yourself doing. Then it is not effective. On the contrary, Prabhupada speaking, to give fitting answer to those who are criticizing Gaudiya Guru Vaishnava, it is called bhakti. But you don't understand. Because you are not following the Prabhupada. So you see, Sansara Sindhu Mati Dustaram Uttitiruyor Nanya Plava Bhagavata Purusha. There is no such boat. There is no such boat. Like the Harikatha from the lotus mouth of Guru Vaishnava. Sansara Sindhum Oti Dustaram, very fearful. Very fearful. Prabhupadananda Saraswati was speaking now. It is full of shark, crocodile, octopus, all water, aquatic animals there. So, Prabhupada Saraswati was speaking. It's full of Kalaha Kalir Varina Indiya Vairi Varga. Bhaktipat iho kantaka koti ruddhu. Countless throne there. How we can cross without the kippa of Guru Vaishnava? Countless throne there. In the way of your devotional life. If you fail to realize actual devotional practice, then you will have to finish your life. Sangsara sindhu mati dustara mutti tiruyor nanya plavo. There is no other boat is suitable than nanya plavo bhagavataha bhagavataha bhagavan, sent by bhagavan. Purushottamasya, purushottamani krishnasya, lila katharasa nishevanam antarena. Nishevanam mane? Not sevanam. Sevanam mane? Seven money to utilize, to lila katha rasam, you will have to take, use. Nishevanam, absolutely you will have to hear. without any argument, without any doubt, without any doubt, without any argument, you will have to hear. Of course, if you think the source is genuine source, if you have doubt, you should not hear. What you can do? So, lila katha rasam, purushottamasya lila katha rasam nishevanam antarena pungsho bhavet vivida duksha dvartitasya. Whereas, burning, all is all jiva, they are burning. Sangsara dava nalanino loko tranayo karunno bhava ghano ghanat praptasya kalyano gunano vasya bandhe gurush. All men, all infighting going on, all different competition going on, but a pure Vaishnava never do competition. His harikatha is absolute, only for the satisfaction of Supreme Lord. Not to make disciple, not to make so many, collect money, position, nothing. This way, actually, we can find that this way we'll have to take help of this Harikatha Amrita from the lotus feet of pure sadhu. So this is the duty of pure sadhu to help us to cross this material ocean, and not only that, but also to help us to attain seva. Ataha dushangam srijya sasu sajjeda buddhima sat santo eva asya chindanti manopyasangam uktibhi. And after that, when after getting real sadhu sangha, sampradayak sadhu sangha, authentic sadhu sangha, then can develop one, you know, very wonderful feeling, sandrananda, or dense, you know, enjoyment, feeling you can get inside heart. But what actually Kapil Muni is speaking to Mother Devahuti, madguna shruti matrena. Whenever a devotee going to hear about the glories of Bhagavan, immediately his mind actually flowing like the flow of Ganga water. Madguna shruti matrena mai sarva guhasai. Sarva guhasai mane everywhere Bhagavan sitting in the form of super soul, Paramatma, everywhere, watching us. Every time Bhagavan going to watching us. We have no way to cheat Bhagavan. We have no way to cheat Bhagavan. Always Bhagavan watching us. Sa sarvadrik upadashta tang bhajanu nirguno bhavet. Sa sarvadrik upadashta, what is watching everything, sitting inside the heart of everybody, and going to watch us, what is our feeling, what is our mood. Madguna suti matrena mai sarva guhasaye manogati ravichinna yatha gangambasa ammadho. Many times I went there, Gomukh, the source of Ganga, to feel that I am nothing in front of Himalaya, in front of, you know, Ganga, in front of, you know, this kind of, I feel I am nothing. So madguna suti matrena mai sarva guhasaye manogati ravichinna yatha gangam basamadhu. A constant flow of, you know, bhava can go manogati ravichinna continuously. To give us this kind of scope, Sri Sanatana Goswami Pad writing this Brihat Bhagavatamrita to give us a direct feeling. Follow. So last week I was discussing that after hearing all glories of Brahma from Indra Maharaj, though he knows he is his father, but still all the time saying in Father, say, if I am close to you, I cannot understand your glory. Sometimes it happens so. Sometimes it happens so. Anyway, after hearing all in details, not that Naraji know nothing. It is for to establish this comparative, you know, statement of bhakti. So actually, Brahma sitting in his own helm, everything I discussed already. After finishing on Yajna, everything, I mean, Brahma engaging his own, you know, sons, Rishi Manis in Yajna, and he wanted to take leave because there is some busyness. So many seva he wanted to. He is going to his own chair, helm. So from there I can discuss. Paramashtyasane tatro sukhasinam nijo prabhu mahimos mahimos sravanakhyanaparam sastrasto netro kam vichitra parameswarjo samagri parisevitam shatatam narado abhetto pranamyo vacho dandavat. Brahma coming back to his own helm, chair, asana, and closing his eyes, eight eyes, wanted to remember, he is remembering the glories of Bhagavan, Mahima, all glories he is thinking, and immediately from eight eyes, tears coming, rolling down his cheeks. It's ecstatic feeling he is feeling. And Brahma Lok, is there is great affluences. Gosvami Pada, they are writing, every fraction of second their scenery changing. I have no direct feeling, I cannot say. Bichitto paramaisarjo samagya parisevitam. Brahma, his affluences, his great affluences there. He is being served. Brahma is being served by different kind of influences. Bichitto, diversified. Bichitto paramaisarjo. Bichitto paramaisarjo samagri parisevitam. And shatatam, shatvatam, narado abhyetto, pranamyo, uvacho dandavat. And Brahma going to sit in his own asana, and in the meantime, Naradji wanted to search opportunity to talk with Father Brahma, but he was busy in the Yajna Kshetra, whereas Yajna Bhagavan was, you know, there already, taking Yajna's share, you know, taking all offerings by devotees, taking, even Brahma also giving. So, Bhagavan, to satisfy all devotees, going to take everything. So that's why there were so many, you know, so many devotees, Rishi Munis and everything. The is full of, you know, devotees. So Brahma was also busy. So he could not, so Narad could not get any scope to talk very, you know, clearly. So he was waiting for the opportunity to come. So now he is going to get opportunity. Maybe he already paid dandavat, but that time Brahma couldn't pay attention. It is quite natural. When Naraji Maharaj reaching Brahma Loka, watching this, that Yajna Bhagavan is there, naturally, he is supposed to pay dandavat to Yajna Bhagavan. At the same time, Brahma also, Brahma is not only father. You should remember, Brahma is not only father. He is also Guru. Krishna is the Chaturmukh, Hare Krishna Sevanmukh, Brahma is the Narada Ramati. So at the same time, his father, like our Prabhupada, never used to speak that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. Never. Prabhupada always used to see the lotus feet of Radharani inside Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Prabhupada told, whenever I look at Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, whenever I look at Bhaktivinoda, I can see all the glories of Radharani inside him. This is called actual darshan. Material darshan is not good. There is a gulf difference between this material world and that transcendental world. There is a gulf difference between the material world and transcendental, Popa speaking. And the color of the gulf is not gulf green. It is, you know, red. Red. Red means the conception of blood and flesh. It is red gulf green. It is red gulf, actually. Full of conception of blood and flesh. Wherever we speak, wherever we look, whatever we speak, all the time, materially we are contaminated. Purity is not there. There is a condition. So anyway, Naraji Maharaj was waiting for the opportunity to come. He wanted to speak something that he couldn't arrange. But now when Brahma coming to his own chair, then Naraji Maharaj going to pay dandavat, very, you know, prostrated dandavat, and then going to speak something to father, or I would say guru, is more practical. See Narada Vacha, then Naraji Maharaj going to speak. Bhagavan, See Narada Vacha, Bhavan eva kipa patram dhruvam bhagavato hare. Bhavan eva kipa patram dhruvam bhagavato hare prajapatir yo vai sarva loko pitamaha. You, I'm sure that you are the kipa patra of Bhagavan Hari. Bhavan means Tatra Bhavan Jat. This is an honorable word. Bhavan is an honorable word. Bayam, Juyam, this is actually, usually we can use. Juyam means you all. Bayam means we all. In Sanskrit we are using. But Bhavan, when you are using, is honorable. Very. So, Bhavan eva. Eva means affirmative. Surely. Bhavan eva kipapatram. Surely you are kipapatra. Dhruvam bhagavato hari. One is dhruvam, one eva. Double. You know. Eva means affirmative. And then again using this. And kipapatam dhruvam, dhruvam manishchitam eva. You are the kipapatro of Bhagavato Hare. Because, prajapatir yo vai sarva loka pitamaha. You are the overall controller of all prajapatis, all beings in this universe. Follow. Sarva loka 14 word. You are pitamaha, topmost honor. Designation. Ekaha srijati pati atti bhavanani chaturdasaha. This 14 world, I think you are going to create, you are going to maintain, and also going to atti, many you are going to destroy. Like one spider going to take, going to make one, you know, network out of the tylin. I mean some liquid coming out from the mouth of, you know, spider is going to make a network. After that the job is over, then going to eat up. Yatro, yeno, yato, yaso, yasmai, yad, yad, yatha, yada, all the case endings of grammar, all applicable, why, how, when, where, from, All everything you can use, all the ultimate result is Bhagavan. That now Naraji Maharaj is going to speak. We have seen that you are creating, you are taking care, also you are going to destroy. What is the meaning? Brahma is not, actually, Brahma is the creator in three forms, but still, Naraji Maharaj is going to speak this way, has some reason, I can explain. Ekaha srijati pati atti bhavanani chaturdasaha brahmandasya ishvaro nityam swayambhur yasya kathate. Swayambhur yasya kathate, everybody know, everybody on Shastra we know that you are yourself coming. We don't know your reason. Swayambhur means will automatically discover his own, So Brahmandasishwara is a Brahmandasishwara. You are Ishwara of this Brahmanda. Nityam Swayambhuscha Kathate. You are known as Swayambhu. Swayambhu, nobody going to make you. But we know how he is created. But now, anyway, Naraji Maharaj speaking this way. Bhavan eva kipa patram dhruvam bhagavato hare prajapatir jo vai sarva loko pitamaha ekaha srijati pati atti bhavanani chaturdasha brahmandasheshwaro nityam swayambhur yascha kathate. After the speaking, actually with this conception, speaking that Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, Bhagavan himself declared, Sijati, Uttipasi, everything. Actually same Bhagavan going to take three forms, Guna Avatar, follow. Sattik, Guna Avatar actually Vishnu, Brahma, Rajagun, Adhishtati, and follow, taking care of creation, and Shankar Bhagavan taking charge of Tamaguna. This way, Bhagavan going to take that, actually called Guna Avatar. With this sense speaking, Sabhayam Jasso Vidyate Murti Manto Artho Bodhaka. Sabhayam, because in your assembly, Sabha, all Ved, Vedanta, Upanishad, physically present. I mean, they have some, personified form. We are getting Veda, Purana, everything, but in book form. Book form, na? Also, you can remember, I already discussed many times, in Chaturmasa time, when Bhagavan going to sleep 4 months in Kirasagar, then Ved Upanishad taking form and going, coming in front of Bhagavan and going to pray in front of Bhagavan during 4 months. So it is customary, it is rules that in 4 months we should not do any rubbish. No, all the time Harikatha Kirtan. Mahaprabhu has shown this kind of idealism. Chaturmasa means Harikatha. But now we are busy with so many things. Harikatha we can say for some time. Follow. There we see Shruti, Siti, Puran, they are going to Ved, Adi, Shruti, they are going to take form. They are going to pray Bhagavan. Jaya jaya ya 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 ma yito dosa grivito guna tamasi yadatmano samabaru dasamasta bhaga aga jaga doko samakila sakta babo dhakati. Very nice. This way, Shruti going to pray, so we are sure Shruti Siddhi Puran, they have the personified form. Follow? So Naraji Maharaj going to speak in front of Gurudev and Father, that Sabhayam Yasso Vidantve Murti Mantu Arthabodhaka Jachatur Bhaktato Yataha Purana Nigamandayo. From your lotus mouth, four mouth, they are taking birth, we know. Actually, Ved Puran actually eternally present. Eternally present, and a creator is Bhagavan. But still, in this material world, for us, Naraji Maharaj speaking, because actually it is written in Shastra, Ved Puran actually coming from the lotus mouth of Brahma. This is the arrangement of Bhagavan, what to do. Vedishya sarve rahame vividhya. Vedo, you know, nishyashita Bhagavan from the, you know, annihilation, exhalation, annihilation. You know, Bhagavan doing, na? This way, actually, Ved Puran we get from Shastra, but anyway, Naraji Maharaj speaking that Jat Chatur Bhaktato, Ved Puran, everything coming, out of the four mouths of Brahma. Savayam Yasso Vidyante Murti Mantu Arthabodhakaha Yachatur Bhaktato Yataha Purano Nigamadayo. Really? Yasso Lokascha Nishidraha Sadharma Chara Nishthaya Madadi Rahitair Shadhir labhate satajanmavi. Jasso lokascho nishchidraha sadharma chara nishchaya. Those who are going to follow, you know, there is no jealousy, no proud, nothing, madam ascharja rohit. Those who are devoid of madam ascharja, everything, that kind of sadhu, those who are going to follow Sadharma, 100s of years, hundreds of birth, without any flawless, those who are flawlessly following their Sadharma Paripak, you know, then after that, it is possible for those Jivatmas, I mean, those sadhu, to reach your loka, I mean Brahma loka. Madho maschajya adhi rahita, devoid of madho maschajya, those sadhus, if they are going to follow, you know, follow flawlessly, shat dharma paripat, follow. Shadharma acharan isthaya, Madadi rahitai sadhir labhates satajanmavi. After hundreds of birth, if they can follow flawlessly their sadharma, in that case, it is possible for them to enter into your Brahmaloka. So, what is the glory of Brahmaloka? You see, this way, Naraji Maharaj going to glorify Brahmaji and his abode, Brahmaloka. Repeatedly speaking, actually we have never seen anything beyond your Brahmaloka. Jasso puri na vidyate brahmande bhuvanam param. We have seen nothing. Brahmaloka is the extreme point. Follow? We have seen nothing. Brahmaloka is the extreme point. Jasso puri na vartate brahmande bhuvanam param. We have never seen. Your Brahmaloka is extreme. And any loka, far, you know, comparatively more better than, far better than you, we have now seen. There is no such loka. And if you can say that Vaikuntha Loka is above, but Vaikuntha Loka is there within your Brahmanda. He is going to speak. Loko Narayana Shapi Vaikuntakha Jadantare. Other Vaikuntha Loka of Narayana also here within your, you know, this, you know, cosmic creation. There, here, inside. Yes, you know, but it is, we will have to realize it. Actually, Vaikuntha Akhya is speaking, Narayana Sapi Vaikuntha Akhya Jadantare. Jadantare means within this 14th world we can discover. Is this mean by the mercy, by the causeless mercy of Supreme Lord, when we can get Rama Vaikuntha, you know, like Sirangam is Astam Vaikuntham, and actually it is written there that Naimisharana is Astam Vaikuntham. For Ranganatham is also compared with Vaikuntha, Jagannath Khetra also, this way Bhati Narayan also, this way actually Naradji wanted to say out of causeless mercy, out of causeless mercy, Bhagavan arranged his own, you know, Vaikuntha Loka to come here to help us. Actually, it is Chinmaya, but we can see a like material. Follow. We can find Vrindavan, Mathura, all we can find here, but it's coming from eternal abode. That's why, with, you know, to glorify Brahma and Brahma Loka, he is speaking this way. Yasso pari na varteta brahmande bhuvanam param. A loko narayana shapi vaikuntakya jadantare. Purushottam khetra deha is vaikuntha actually. Really so. Not, you know, it is false, you know, glorification. Has some meaning. This way, Naraji Maharaj going to glorify Brahma Loka and going to glorify Brahma, his guru. After that speaking, actually, first of all here, wanted to speak, here is some inner meaning. Savayam jasso vidyante murtimanto artho bodhukaha. This meaning is there, that all Veda, Purana, everything in personified from their, you know, staying there in Brahmaloka, there is one indication. We are going to follow Shastra, we are going to follow Sadhuguru Vishnava to regulate our life very, you know, accurately. There's some inner meaning there. Why Brahma, why Nara speaking this way? Has some inner meaning. If there is, you know, Ved, Purana, everything in personified form, and we know we are following Shastra or Sadhuguru Vaishnava to regulate our life very accurately, without any fault, there is one indication that your Loka, I mean Brahma Loka, is so important. So important, so valuable, so we can glorify it, that all Veda Puranas we are going to follow, those who are, you know, staying in other lokas, they are going to follow. And those Veda Puranas are already there. So naturally their system on the environment is very holy environment, in which those who are the inhabitant of this place feeling comfortable, very peace. They are also, you know, pious, you know, very pure. This way, there is no jealousy, no, you know, fighting, no greed, no politics, nothing. So other people, they cannot reach. Only those who are pious men, they are following, you know, hundreds of birds, those sadhus, they are going to accurately, flawlessly going to follow sadharma, they can reach. So you see the glories of your loka. This way, this is the inner meaning. After that, Naraji Maharaj is going to speak. Jasmin nityam vasit sakshat maha purusha vigraha. In your loka, practically I see that Yajna Purush, Bhagavan is there, staying, always going to approve your Yajna, going to accept all your offerings personally. You know, follow. Jasmin Nityam Basit, Shakshat Mahapurusha Vigraha. So Padyanabho Yajnanam Bhagana Asnano Dadat Phalam. Here is one indication. So Padyanabho, there is indication that Brahma already discovered himself sitting in a lotus flower. He wanted to search the source of his birth, but he couldn't trace out. Sa paddanabho yajnanam bhagano asnano dadat phalam. Naraji Maharaj speaking, in your loka, Brahma loka, he is sitting, he is there already. Yasmin nityam baset is, you know, nityam baset, if I say eternally, it is not good. Because Brahma loka is not eternally present, that argument can come. Brahma can go on speaking. But we can say this much, regular presence of Bhagavan there. We can find Bhagavan anytime. This much we can say. Because Brahma loka is not eternal. Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Punaravarti Nahi Arjuna. Bhagavan himself told to Arjuna. Arjuna, right from ant and Abrahma Bhuvana Loka. From Brahma Lok up to Abrahma Bhuvana Loka, this material world, everything, all rotating in cyclic order. Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam, Punarapi Matri Jatare Sayanam. There is no alternative. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi matri ijatare sayanam. This compulsory. Compulsory it is in this material world. So Jasmin Nityam, who is present there. Nitya noimittik karma, na? Those were karma kandi they are speaking. Nitya noimittik karma. We think the duty of Atma, Nitya Naimittik Mana Amar Bhajan. But those Karmakandi, they think those are daily ritualistic activities, they speak this way. So there is a scope of confusion. So Nitya Naimittik Karma is separate, and Nitya Karma, the eternal duty of Atma. We are doing anik, japa, everything, you know, we are doing to get our eternal life. It is involved, it is related with our Atma, not with body. Follow what I say. So, jasmin nityam baset sakshat mahapurusha vigraha. That mahapurusha vigraha, Bhagavan, yajna purush, is, you know, we can find him in this loka always. Sa paddanabho yajnanam bhagano asnano dadat phalam. His name is Padyanabho. Sa paddanabho. This indication here, going to speak this Padyanabho, I mean wanted to give indication that actually you have taken birth from, you know, that Padyanabho, you know, you are Sambhu, nobody going to create birth. Actually the secret reason is that you take birth in the navel stem of Narayan. Sa Padyanabho. Padyanabho. Also we can say whose navel part is, you know, can be compared with Padma. Actually we have not, we cannot find anything, any object or anything with which we can compare the lotus feet of Bhagavan, lotus mouth of Bhagavan. What to do? That's why ultimately we are bound to speak a lotus feet, lotus mouth, lotus hand, this way. No other way. Because there is no, we cannot find anything with which we can compare the lotus feet of Bhagavan. Like Tulsidas ji wanted to compare the face, you know, of Ramchandra, but finally wanted to search out some, you know, nice thing in this material creation, like Surya Sun God or Moon God. But finally, he wanted to compare mouth with Sun God. No, 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 it's burning condition, a sunlight. No, no, I cannot compare. Moon God, no, there is some, you know, spot in the face of Moon God, so I cannot compare. This way, ultimately, Tulsidas ji was bound to speak that Raghuvar ke mukh saman Raghuvar mukh baniya. As the lotus mouth of Raghuvar, I mean Ramchandra, is compared with the face of Raghuvar. There is no other thing. Follow what I say. Raghuvar ke mukh saman. When we are going to compare anything with something, upaman, upama, shamas, we are speaking. Like we say, your face is very good, like you know, moon, mukhachandra. We are speaking this way. But with which object we can compare the lotus mouth of Ramchandra? Tulsidas ji ultimately wanted to declare the lotus mouth of Ramchandra can be compared only with the lotus mouth of Ramchandra. Tulsidas going to compare this way. So this way, what to do? This material world, all material things, with which, you know, but there is also material going to, you know, if you keep it in sunlight, you can, you know, lose this, you know, glamour. Actually, after that, speaking, jasmin nityam vaset sakshat mahapurusha vigraha sa padyanabho yajnanam bhagana asnano. Bhagavan himself, padyanabho, going to take the share of jagya directly, and after taking, going to give blessings to everybody. Dadat phalam. Dadat phalam means result. Is going to give result, I mean blessings to everybody. Paraman neshana, wherever it is written, paraman neshanaya sai yashod desho upi na taya pura praptaha param drishtaha stapovhir riti yah chanam. Follow. You, he Gurudev, he Pritha, you, in the beginning of Kalpa, Adi Kalpa, Adi Kalpa, first Kalpa, in the, you know, you, yourself, in Adi Kalpa, you know, you wanted to discover the reason of your, you know, birth, Annesha Netu, you wanted to go deep into the stem, you could not find any starting or end, again you unnecessarily, you give so much energy, and being failure, you again come back on the seat, I mean the Padma. Follow. So Naraji Maharaj speaking, you yourself in Adi Kalpa wanted to search him out, very, very, you know, great, by out of great effort, you wanted to search out the reason, but you could not trace out any reason, cause and effect. There is no, you couldn't find. After that, somehow, you started Australian finances tapasya, very hard tapasya, and by the mercy of Bhagavan, inside your heart, you could see that Bhagavan for a very short period. Hidaya Khetre, you could discover. Out of causeless mercy, Bhagavan appeared inside your heart to give you darshan, what is dham, everything, like Chatusloka. Chatusloka, you know? Everything. Bhagavan going to give darshan, everything. परमान्वेषणायैर यस्योद्देशो उपि न तया पूरा प्राप्तः परम दृष्टः स्तपोभिर् हृदि यः क्षणम्। फॉर ए वेरी शॉर्ट टाइम यू कुड सी हिम, ही अपीयर्ड इनसाइड योर हार्ट। दिस इज द स्टेटस, यू नो, कंडीशन, यू नो। You wanted to search out, but you couldn't, you know, search. You couldn't. Really so. Tat sattam asi krishnasya tameva nityam priyo. Really so. There is no doubt. The conclusion is that tat sattam asi krishnasya tameva nityam priya. You are very, very, you know, dear Kipa Patra of Bhagavan. No doubt, Krishna sir. Aho, nunam sa eva tvam lila nana bapurdhara. Aho, nunam sa eva tvam. Actually, what to speak more? You are yourself that Supreme Lord. According to lila, you are going to take this kind of form. So, if I say that tat sattamasi krishnasya tameva nityam priya, this is also not full definition, full glorification. Still, something I like to say, aho nunam sa eva tvam lila nana bapurdhara. According to different kind of lila, you are going to take this kind of form. What to see? You are yourself the Supreme Lord. I realize that way. It's just definitely. You are that Param Purush, Mahapurush. According to Leela, you are going to take this kind of form. What to say? So this way, Naraji Maharaj, one by one, going to glorify. Naraji Maharaj, one by one, going to glorify his, you know, guru and father, both. Follow? Tat sattam oshi krishna satameva nityam nitaram priya. Sorry. Tat sattam oshi krishna satameva nitaram. Nitaram mane definitely. Otishay. Netaramane Otisha, very, very dear. So the reading is Tat Sattamasi Krishnasya Tameva Nitaram Priya Priyaha. Aho Nunam Sa Eva Tvam Leela Nana Bapurdhara. This way Naraji Maharaj is going to glorify best possible way. Now Parikshit Maharaj in the meantime going to speak. Actually Parikshit Maharaj is going to speak to Uttarama. In between what he is describing, we are going to read this way. Then Narada Vacha, this Vacha. All actually Parikshit Maharaj speaking actually. So Parikshit Vacha. And Parikshit also heard from Jaimini Muni. Follow? I already told. So Parikshit Vacha here. इत्यं महात्म उद्गायन विस्तार्जो ब्रह्मणो असकृत शक्रो प्रक्तम सदृष्टंच भक्त्यासित त्वं नमन मुनि। परीक्षित महाराज स्पीकिंग, नारजी महाराज watching all the glories of that Dhamma and the glories of Brahma. He hears all glories from Indra Maharaj, but still he is watching more what he heard from Indra Maharaj. He is going to glorify again and again, going to do kirtan of that glories. And out of his craving heart, going to pay namaskar pranam unto the lotus feet of that Brahma ji Pitamaha. इत्यम महात्म उद्गायन विस्तार जो ब्रह्मणो असकृत शक्रो प्रक्तम सदृष्टंच भक्त्यासित्वम नमन मुनि। नारद जी महाराज गोइंग टू पे दंडवत इज वेरी Parikshit Maharaj also speaking, what is the condition of Brahma after hearing. Parikshit Maharaj is going to explain this point. Srinun eva, after hearing, tad bhakyam, I mean the glories from the lotus mouth of, you know, Naraji Maharaj, his son, disciple. Srinun eva sa tad bhakyam, दासोस्मि इति मुहुर्ब्रुवन बदन। हियर इट इज इन सम प्लेस इट इज ब्रुवन मुहुर्ब्रुवन समटाइम्स सम प्लेस इट इज मुहुर्बदन बदन स्पीकिंग। चतुर्भक्तो अष्टकर्णानां पिधाने व्याघ्रतां गतः श्रृण्वन्नेव आफ्टर हियरिंग ऑल द ग्लोरीज फ्रॉम द लोटस माउथ ऑफ नारदजी महाराज Brahmaji was feeling very, very, you know, shy. He was feeling very shy. And immediately wanted to, you know, choke the plug of ear plug, ear, you know, hearing organ. Wanted to stop so that this kind of glories cannot enter into the ear of Brahma. Brahma wanted to stop with finger, wanted to stop. Earflag. Srinan eva satat bhakyam. No, no, don't speak that way. Don't speak that way. I am actually servant. Dasosmiti muhur badan. Repeatedly speaking, don't speak that. I am actually servant. So this way repeatedly, Brahma going to speak out. Out of, you know, very humble attitude, you know, shyness. Srinan eva sa tad bhakyam dasasmiti muhurvadan chaturbhakto ashto karnanam pidhane vyagratam gataha. Wanted to immediately stop ear, hearing organ, so that this kind of glories cannot enter their fear. Always, it is the nature of pure Guru Vaishnava. They never like to hear personal glories. They don't like to hear. It's quite natural. You know, chatur bhakto astakarnanam pidhane vyakritam gataha asrabbo sarvanat jatam kopam jatneno dharayan saputram naradam praho shakhepam chaturananah. What? Bhaja srinan eva satat bhakyam dasosmi iti muhur badan chatur bhakto ashtakarnanam pidhane vyagratam gataha. Ar asrabro sarvanat jatam. We should not hear this kind of glory with this kind of mood. No, no, I should not hear this kind of asrabro. I should not hear. This kind of, you know, exaggerated things, glories. No. Asrabbo sravanat jatam. After hearing this kind of thing, he was feeling little bit, expressing angry attitude, but somehow wanted to control himself. It is written, asrabbo sravanat. After hearing what he was not expecting to hear from Narad, that kind of thing hearing, so naturally he was feeling some angry attitude, but somehow wanted to control his angry attitude. Asrabra sabana jatam kupam yatne nadharayan wanted to control. And after the speaking heavily, Shaputram Naradam Praho Shakhepam. With regret, I feel regret that you are speaking that way. This way, Brahma speaking with regretful attitude to Swaputra Naradam, Chaturananaha. Chaturanan. Brahma going to speak this very, 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 he is feeling disturbed. Feeling disturbance. Why you are speaking this way? Eh? See, now actually, Parikshit Maharaj speak this way. After that, see Brahma Vacha. Brahma, what Brahma wanted to speak? He is speaking, Aho, no, Bhagavan Krishna, iti twankim pramanataha, yuktitascha, maya viknam, bodhitosi no ballata. Aham no Bhagavan. I am not Bhagavan Krishna. Aham no Bhagavan Krishna. Iti twankim pramanataha, yuktitascha, maya aviknam bodhitosi no ballataha. From your childhood, you can remember. From your childhood, I was giving different kind of scriptural evidence to establish that I am not at all Krishna. You forget? Eh? Foolish, you forget? Aham na Bhagavan Krishna iti tvam king pramanataha yuktitascha maya avhiknam bodhitosi na ballataha. From your childhood, I was given this kind of argument, a different kind of documents, scriptural evidence, that I am not at all Bhagavan Krishna. No. He is my master. I am servant. Actually, Narad, you should know, Tasho Shaktir Mahamaya Dasi Bhikshapati Sthita Srijati Idam Jagatpati Shagunai Sangharati Yogi. Narad, actually, the Shakti of Bhagavan, Sri Krishna, say Bhagavan, that Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, His Shakti Mahamaya, according to the indication of that Supreme Lord, a maid servant, you know, according to the order of Bhagavan, going to Sisti Siti Palaya Sadhana Shakti Rekha Chayeva Yasso Bhuvanani Vivarti Durga Ichchan Rupa Mapi Yasso Cha Chishtate Sa Gavinda Madhi Purusham Tamaham Bajami. You can remember, na? Brahma Sangita. So Brahmaji Maharaj speaking, that Krishna, His Mahamaya, Shakti Mahamaya, according to the instruction of His Master, acting as a maid servant, you know, and going to do, by the help of Sataraja Tamagun Gun Samodara, according to Sataraja Tamagun, going to create this material world, going to take care of this material world, I mean maintenance, creation, maintenance, and the destruction, all done by this Mahashakti. You should know. Tasho Shaktir Mahamaya Dashi Bhikshapati Sthita Srijati Idam Jagatpati Sagunai Sangharatiyopi. You know. And Tasha eva bayam sarve opi adhina mahito staya. We are hypnotized by the magic spell of that maya. We all. Tasha eva bayam. Bayam mean I am Brahma, Sankar, Indra, all. Bayam mean we all. So Indra, Brahmaji Maharaj is going to claim that Tasha, I mean that Shakti, by the power Shakti of that, you know, Mahamaya. Tasha eva bayam sarve opi adhina. We are under the control of that, you know, Mahashakti. And not only that, but also we are hypnotized by the magic spell of that Maya. Who not? Everybody. Who? Mama Maya Durataya. You don't know? Eh? Mami Vyo Prapadante Maya Maitan Taranti, the Bhagavan speaking. So you see, Tasya Evo Bayam Sarve Opi Adhina Mahitostaya. Tanno Krishna Kripa Lesoswapi Patram Mabehimam. Never think. Never think. Not at all. That I am the, you know, slightest kipa patra of Bhagavan. No, no, no. No trace of kipa. No, no, no trace of kipa there with me. Never think that way. So, tasya eva vayam sarve upi adhina mahitvastaya tanno krishna kripa lesasvapi patram avehimam. Never try to think that I am enjoying a little, you know, slight kipa Bhagavan. No, not at all. I am hypnotized by the magic spell of Maya and always have some false ego. Oh, I am the creator. Actually, tan maya yoiva satatam jagato aham guru prabhu. I am the guru. I am the master of this creation. I am Prabhu. I am Pitamahascha Krishnasya Nabhi Padma Samadbhavaha. I am always, you know, thinking that way. I am Jagat Guru, Prabhu, Pitamaha. This way, always I am going to express false ego. Krishna, you know, Pita. So, Tanmaya Yaiva Satatam Jagato Aham Guru ho Prabhu, Pita Mahascha Krishnasya Nabhi Padma Samadbhava. I am coming from the navel stem of Sri Krishna. I have done Astridian Pranansa so much and also doing today. This kind of false ego always going to give me, you know, pain. This kind of false ego always going to, you know, give me backup so that I have no bhajan. So, aham tapasi, I am as doing a study in balances. I have done so much, you know, aradhana bhajan of Bhagavan. Itari, this kind of heavy, etc., this kind of heavy false ego always going to destroy me, my real self. Especially, I am going to take care of this, you know, of this material world. Always visible material creation. Material creation means you know, oh my son, you know what kind of disturbance there, eh? You know? What kind of big headache it is, you know, still I am busy with all this thing. So how you can say I am Kipa Patra? So, Tanmaya Yoiva Satatam Jagato Aham Guruhu Prabhu Pita Mahascha Krishnasya Nabhi Padma Samadbhava. This kind of bhavga. Ar Tapasya Radhakaha. Tashetvadvair gurum madair hataha. Guru madair hataha. This kind of heavy, you know, false ego appear. And Brahman, Brahmandavashyaka, aparo beparo, beparo, amarsavirha, bivhalala. Because the material creation is, you know, such a, you know, headache, big headache. That Brahmandava Shaka Aparo Beparam Amarso Vyohala. I am going to take charge of this thing. So naturally I feel puzzled sometime. Disturbance. Eh? So, bhuta prayatmo lokiyo naso chinta niyantritaha sarva sarva grasi maha kalad bhito muktim param brine. I am going to take charge of different kind of, you know, job, their seva, given by Bhagavan, actually, in this Brahmanda. So, naturally, a creation means is Rajagun, so I am feeling disturbance all the time. And always I am having some different unknown fear. Not unknown, actually, I have some idea that somehow I am going to get destroyed. This loka, my Brahma loka, and in this all bhuta, bhuta gram, and my abode is also not permanent. Sarvos sangharak mahakal, you know? Mahakal, you know, mahakal mean time. Mahakal mean time. Time is nothing but movement, progress, follow, all. So, this Mahakal going to crash down everything in course of time. So, I am also fearful, I have some anxiety, tension. I am full of tension all the time because busy with this material creation, what to do? I am the in charge, so naturally I am going to take charge. You know, all the time I am busy. Says, you know, it's Rajagun matter. Rajagun matter can never be peaceful. I am always feeling disturbance. Not only that, but also time and tide wait for Nam. Proceeding, Mahakal going to swallow. Gradually, Mahakal going to swallow me and my loka, everything. Always some sort of tension and anxiety going to follow me. When I can get to swa, I don't know. This way, be sure, Narad, my son, you are speaking so much thing, but I only thinking how to get, you know, mukti. You are glorifying me big way. I am devotee, I am the kipapatra, this, that. So many things you are speaking. I never wanted to hear that kind of thing. Unexpected, but you are glorifying me that way. But don't try to understand what is my status, what is my position. Follow. Only I am, you know, out of fear, anxiety, tension, always going to pray to Bhagavan, Muktim Parambrine. If at least I can get mukti, that is more than enough. You are speaking so many things. Out of humble mood, Brahmaji Maharaj speaking that way. I can never expect anything. Only mukti I am asking. Muktim param brini. I know, always fearing when I can get destroyed, this kind of thing. Only maximum I like to, you know, pray, Bhagavan, give me mukti, mukti. I am full of fear, always tension and anxiety going to, you know, follow me. So please, muktim param brine. So you are glorifying me big way, what I can seek. This way, one by one, Pitama Brahma wanted to show different cause for why he cannot expect that kind of glorification. He is going to speak clearly in front of Naraji, his son. That's why he is going to glorify this winner. Though we know that Brahma is going to live for a long time, calculation regarding that mathematical calculation I was speaking, you know, 1 week before. But still, Brahma speaking, this no, there is no stability. There is no stability. No, nothing. So we are always full of tension and anxiety. Tadaham Bhagavat Pujam Karenami Karomicha Avaso Jagadishasu Ba Nakobidati Tadartham. I am full of fear. There is anxiety, tension, and fear. Tadartham, that's why, out of that fearful attitude, I am doing Bhagavad Puja. It is not, you know, mutual love affair. You misunderstand, actually. Tadartham Bhagavad Pujam Karen Nami Karoticha. I am allowing my, you know, my sons and everybody, relatives, those who are son, everything, to do worship, also myself also doing. I want to arrange puja. I always want to arrange puja of Bhagavan by my son, you know, by my son and servants, everybody, wife, all. I want to arrange the puja of Bhagavan by them so that they can also get busy and in relation to Bhagavan. I can also get some kripa. So I allow them to do, I allow them to do, you know, archan, puja, everything, and also myself, I myself also doing. I arrange the puja of Bhagavan by them, also I myself doing. So be sure, I am full of tension, tadartham, that is why, Bhagavat pujam karen nami karoti cha. I am allowing, you know, all my, you know, parshadas, those who are my son and every servants there, to do worship of Bhagavan. At the same time, I myself also doing, just to get, you know, kripa, I mean, mukti. And you are speaking, all the avas, the abode of Bhagavan is there within your brahmanda, within your 14 loka. But my question is that, avaso jagadishasya ba na kavidyate. Bhagavan is omnipresent. Bhagavan is omnipresent, Bhagavan everywhere. So you are speaking, oh, Bhagavan is there in your loka, so you are lucky. Bhagavan is there in your loka all the time staying, so you are lucky. You cannot speak that way. Bhagavan is omnipresent everywhere. No stability. Sometime here, sometime there, Bhagavan. You watching that Bhagavan is there. Avaso jagadishasya ba na kavidyate. Where you cannot find? Everywhere Bhagavan. You know, when Prahlad speak, when Hiranyakashipu was asking, hey, your Prabhu is there inside this pillar? Prahlad with strong belief say, yes, yes, Bhagavan is also there. So Hiranyakashipu is going to destroy with one fist of fury, wanted to break. And after that, Hiranyakashipu could discover really so. In between that pillar, you know, he discovered one strange, not animal, not lion, not man, half lion, half man, coming out. Who is that? Could not realize. Our commentator, they are going to explain that at the time of death, though Nrisimhadev going to, you know, kill him, but still, at the time of killing, at the time of death, at the time of death, Hiranyakashipu could not realize, could not feel that this half lion, half man, he is no other than Supreme Lord. He could not realize. The Chakravarti Bhad, Siddha Swami Bhad, Vishwanath Chakravarti Bhad, all speaking. At the time of death, he could not realize. Ravana also same. At the time of death, could not realize that is Supreme Lord. That's why there's problem. So you see, Where is not Bhagavan? Everywhere Bhagavan is resting. There is nothing new. This is nothing new. You can say the Bhagavan is there. Bhagavan is everywhere. And also, I told you already, there is no stability. Sometime Bhagavan staying in Dwarka, that also not always. Sometime running to, you know, Hastinapur or, you know, Indraprastha. Sometime going here and there. So all the time busy, Bhagavan. So actually, to be frank, actually, where not Bhagavan staying? As per Shastra, we can find, even when dust particle, there is a presence of Bhagavan, if you can believe. If you cannot believe, then in the deity also you cannot see Bhagavan. Follow. Those who can see clearly, they can see everything clear. Like Rai Ramandu watching Krishna inside Mahaprabhu. Prabhu, who you are? Speak clearly. Oh, actually I am sannyas. No! Speak clearly, who are you? I just have seen that inside you, that Radharani, Krishna going to embrace Radharani, going to take that body complexion and mood, and now I see you are Gaurhari. Please speak, who are you? This way, Mahaprabhu going to speak, you are actually Mahabhagavat. Actually you are Mahabhagavat, so you can see the presence of Bhagavan everywhere. No, you speak clearly, who are you? Finally, Mahaprabhu was bound to disclose his own identity, wanted, you know, that actually don't speak to anybody. I am actually Joker, and you are actually, you know, so, Batul, I am Batul, you are Batul, Balamani, foolish, and you are foolish. So don't speak to anybody. So, Allah finally wanted to show Rai Ramananda, that he is Gauranga Bapu, he is Radha Govinda. Anyway, so in this context, I like to speak that Brahma speaking, Bhagavan staying everywhere, omnipresent. So you are speaking, he is staying within this 14th world, he has some, you know, loka, Rama, Vaikuntha, this, that. It's quite natural. And also, Bebo Bedo Pavartanaya Sau Bhagam Grinnanti Kevalam Swayam Sangpadito Presto Yogyasvano Gruhaya Cha. Are you are speaking, giving some argument? Oh, Bhagavan going to personally, Bhagavan going to take the share of Jagya. That also some secret reason. Oh, my son. Also, there is some secret reason. Because if Bhagavan is going to violate all rules and regulations, who can follow? Jajja sestra devetaro janaha sayat pramanam, you know, this sloka you know, na? So he is the important personality. If he is not going to follow, who is going to care? That's why he is going to set the system, to show us the, you know, activities, to show us the efficacy. He is going to accept, actually. It is actually a curse, not out of love. If Bhagavan not going to accept, you know, Jagga share, then how Bhagavan can give instruction, a Veda, Purana, here, who can do? So that's why he is doing. It's not out of love for me. Not that. He loved me, that's why I do. No, not at all. You know, you are speaking, he is taking Jagga back directly. Well, he is going to take, you know, Yogya Bhag is not out of love for me. His own, you know, indication, some, you know, order is there, Agyarup. He wanted to establish Veda, Purana, you know, and how to follow it, you know, how to follow the system to establish this Vedic rules and regulation. If he is not going to do himself, in the form of Yagya Murti, who man care to for? That's why Yagya Vidhi, oh, this kind of Yagya there, and his this kind of Yagya there, this kind of, you know, Yagya Bhag, share of Yagya is going to take personally. All this has some secret reason. Not that he is going to love me, I am Kripabhata, that's why. So you are thinking that way, now I am going to speak. Follow what I say. वेदो वेदो प्रवर्तनयसौ भागम गृह्णाति केवलम स्वयं स्वयं संपादितो पृष्ठ यज्ञानुग्रहाय च एन विचाराचार्य बुधस्य स ही भक्तिक वल्लभ कृपां तनोति भक्तिषु नाभक्तेषु कदाचन वे विचाराचार्य हो नारद दैट कृष्ण वर इज हिज हार्ट यू नो ही ओनली लव डिवोटीज एंड डिवोटीज दे आर लविंग मदन्नते नायनंति नाहम तेभ्य मनागोपी फॉलो इज भक्त प्रिय दोज डिवोटीज लव हिम एंड ही लव डिवोटीज आई एम नॉट डिवोटीज हाउ यू कैन लव मी हाउ यू कैन लव मी हाउ आई कैन बिकम ए कृपा पात्र दैट कृष्ण is only and only bhaktya aham ekaya labhya only out of bhakti one can get the kripa of bhagavan nothing else I have no bhakti na an kunti devi also speaking there janma isvarjo suto sivi redhamano madha apmano naiva arhati avidatum bai tamakinchana gocharam people they are busy with their false ego because of their taking birth in high family race aristocracy their education appliances and nice figure they are going to do. So Kunti Devi speaking they actually popped up their false ego they have they never can get kripa of Bhagavan only niskinchan bhakta they only can get the kripa so janma isajya sruto sivir रेदमान मदहपमान नैव अर्हति अविदातुम मई तमा किंचन गोचन ओ भगवान ओनली एंड ओनली दोज आर निष्किंचन भक्त दे एंड दे ओनली दे कैन रियलाइज यू दे कैन गेट यू सो यू सी विचार आचार्य बुद्धस्य स ही भक्तैक वल्लभः यू नो ना भक्तैक वल्लभः Only he like bhakti, nothing else. But I have no bhakti. Kipam tanoti bhaktesu na bhaktesu kadachana. Out of humble attitude, Brahma wanted to express his humble attitude. The only you can know the heart of Krishna Bhagavan. He only love devotees, and those devotees they love him. So it's a mutual understanding. I am not actually devotees. Navakti, Navakti said, "I am non-devotee. How you can say that I am the kripa patra Bhagavan? This is not good. And what to speak about kripa? Bhakti dure astu, tasmin me na aparad bhavanti chet. What to Narad? You are speaking big thing. You are glorifying me big way. But I am only out of my fearful attitude. I am thinking, I scare, I fear that sometime I can mistake unto lotus feet of Bhagavan. Bhakti dure astu. What to speak about bhakti is amrita. I am not thinking about up to that point. Bhakti dure astu. Tasmin me na aparad bhavanti chet. By chance, if I can save myself from aparad. That I think my big achievement. You are speaking so big thing. Dure astu, bhakti dure astu. What to speak about bhakti? Where is the amrita? Where is the treasure? My bhakti ni bhutanam amrita tayakalpate. You forget na? Bhakti dure astu. What to speak about bhakti? Tasmin me na paradha bhavanti chet. बहुमन्ने तदात्मनम नाहम मागसु रुद्रवत् बाय चांस इफ आई कैन नॉट मेक एनी मिस्टेक अन टू लोटस फीट दैट आई थिंक हैवी बिग अचीवमेंट फॉर मी बिकॉज आई हैव सीन माय सॉन्ग इट इज प्रैक्टिकल एक्सपीरियंस आई हैव सीन भगवान always going to excuse Rudra, is friendly with him. I have seen Bhagavan always going to excuse, you know, Rudra, I mean Mahadev, Shankar, always he is going to excuse. But he never going to excuse my aparad, you don't know. Never. Bhagavan never going to, you know, never going to excuse me. I am in a very tight situation where you are going to glorify me. Eh? You don't know? I can speak. Then you can realize. So many times I have done mistake. Those demons, Hiranyaka, Hiranyakasipu, Ravan, Kumbhakarna, they are also always going to, you know, astute and finances they are doing, they are calling me, what to do? I think I am Pritamavishya, so somehow I am going to respond to their call, I am going there. It is also my offense, because when I am going to give them benediction, it is dangerous. They are going to disturb the whole world, they are going to upset all the system, going to, you know, upset, all upset. See, also one kind of offense I have done now. But I cannot stop myself. I am bound to go. They are calling me all the time. Ravan calling me. Eh? Sometime I have given, you know, benediction boon to Ravan. You know the case of Hiranyakasipu also. But what to do? This is one kind of offense I am doing. This is one kind of offense. What Bhagavan never approved. And also, follow. Also, the case I can discuss tomorrow. Today, time over. Tomorrow, I can show when the Govatsa Haran Leela, when all the coward boys and a calf were abducted by Brahma, Bhagavan was not satisfied. Bhagavan was not satisfied. But Bhagavan somehow wanted to show Kripa to Indra. Why? Indra has done offense. He has also, as he is going to pray, please excuse me. I have done offense. Please excuse me. I couldn't realize you. Please excuse me. But somehow Bhagavan is going to bear. Because offense done by Indra going to fulfill the desire of Krishna. Follow what I say. Offense done by Indra, but some desire inside the heart of Brajavasis, inside the heart of Krishna, all along been there. They all wanted to stay with Krishna continuously, non-stop, at a stretch, without any break. Because morning time, Krishna Geta, running to Goshala, after that from there coming, then taking birth, taking some prasadam, taking preparation to go to for, you know, posturing field with coward boys, together with coward boys and, you know, calves, going. And when Krishna become aged, then going with cow also. So this way, and also we cannot, at forest, it is written, banat banam. There is no security that he is going to stay in one forest. He is so chanchal. No surety that I can go and search. I have seen Krishna going to Kamban. I can go and search him. No. He is there from there. He is running here and there. No stability. Sometime here, sometime there, sometime here, sometime there. So you see. Follow. This way, I can establish Siddhanta tomorrow by the mercy of Sanatana Goswami and all your mercy. Guru Bhargava. There and you all, I can try to establish that how Brahmaji going to, you know, going to avoid his own pratishtha, self-pratishtha. Also true it is that many times when Rudra Bhagavan, I mean Shankar Bhagavan doing some mistake, Bhagavan going to excuse you very. Follow. But Brahma usually not getting Kripa so easily. That's why you can go through Bhagavatam text. There you can find the stava I mean the prayer of Brahma, I prayer, prayer of Indra was not so long. But the prayer of Brahma was long, 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 even after that. Bhagavan was not so satisfied. Because though both of them, Indra done mistake, aparat, Brahma also done some aparat, but still, due to the aparat of Indra, Indra has done some aparat, but this is going to satisfy some inner meaning. Yeah. Indra has done some aparat, but anyway, is going to fulfill the desire of Brajavasis and Krishna also. They always, this has all along been their desire, they wanted to stay together with Krishna for a certain time because there is no stability, that's why. So this is a question. Tomorrow I can discuss all in details about this. Excuse me for the time, I beg for pardon.
Sansar sindhu mati dustaram uttitaryor nanyo plava bhagavatah purushottamasya lila katharaso nishevanam antarena pungso bhavet vivida dukshadavarditasya
vanchakalpadurusya kipasindhu vyavasya patitanang pavana gopeshna phyo namo.